Lad, Tommy Fury got back to winning ways tonight. 10-round UD of Marius Vak. Two scorecards, 100-90. One scorecard, 91-99. Tommy Fury. Yeah. Right, well, he was definitely fleshier than I'm used to seeing him. I think they said he was something like 2 stone heavier than he was in his last fight. It definitely showed. Tommy Fury is such an interesting case because we're hearing the same stuff for the last 3 years. Oh, it's his age. Oh, now he's developing his man strength. Oh, now it's this, now it's that, now it's this. Same. It's like a broken record, right? He came out early on trying to insert himself, trying to take Marius Vak out of there. All right. Now, Tommy Fury is not noted as a big puncher. Marius Vak is known for probably having the best chin in the heavyweight division, bar none. I mean, I know he's been stopped a few times, but that's been stopped on volume. And the Povetkin, it was a cut. He's known for having a tremendous chin. So when Fury came out trying to be aggressive, he looked a bit ungainly. It was just kind of a clash because they were kind of a bit all over. They were kind of tangled in one another, a bit all over the place for the first few rounds. It was really after the 6th round where Tommy Fury started boxing a bit. Now, we're used to seeing Tommy Fury up on his toes, moving around the ring, flicking out a jab. I suspect we didn't see him doing that in this fight for several reasons. I'm assuming he really did go in there thinking, right, I want to stop Marius Vak. I want to make a statement. As I said, that's all well and good. But this is a guy who's durable, who's not been stopped, who's been in there with big punchers, huge punchers, like Klitschko, to be able to take their shots. So, a stoppage was never on the cards for me. And seeing Tommy Fury as the aggressor, you can tell he's not used to it because he looked very ungainly. Now, to be fair, Marius Vak was probably not the ideal opponent you want to be trying aggression with because they were kind of just meeting in the middle and they were just kind of going all over the place. There were shots missing. Tommy Fury actually got tagged with a few right hands. I think it was the 3rd round. Marius Vak did land actually a very good right hand on Tommy Fury's chin. Marius Vak not known as a devastating puncher, but look what he did to Christian Hammer. And go and look and see who else has done that. No one. So Tommy took a few shots in there. The real kind of note of this fight was the 4th round. Was where the both guys were in the corner. They got into an exchange. And then there was a clash of heads. It opened that cut. Like that cut. That's a worry. Because that cut is still there for Tommy Fury. The one over the eye. Now he sustained that cut in the Pulev fight 2 years ago. I'm assuming it was pre-existing. Because I remember it was a jab from Kubrat Pulev that originally started the cut. But I think that cut must have been pre-existing from sparring. That's 2 years later and that cut is still reopening. Because it reopened, I think, in the Povetkin fight to a lesser extent. Now, this wasn't from a punch. This was from a clash of heads. But it is still a worry when the cut is there for about 2 years, maybe more. And it's still reopening when it gets a bit of force on it. And it was quite, like, what I was watching, like, I'm watching this on the Zone feed. And basically, it kind of, on their feed, I could see it was there. And I could see it was flown, but didn't look as bad. And then I just go and had a quick look on Instagram. And MTK posted a picture of it. And it did actually look quite bad, look quite deep. So that's going to keep Tommy Fury. That's going to be a worry for him moving forward with that cut. Because as I said, it can get open with a clash of heads. Or it could be open by a punch. Because we've seen it open by punch before. That's going to be a worry. After the 6th round was when Tommy Fury just got back on his bike, started boxing, started moving around the ring. I suspect one of the reasons why he didn't do it as well is because being 2 stone or heavier, maybe he just doesn't have the foot speed and maybe he just doesn't have the legs to be able to do that at that weight. Because as I said, he did look very, Huey's normally in decent shape. He looked, I'm not going to say he looked fat, he didn't look fat, but he looked very fleshy. You could tell that the weight he gained wasn't muscle, right? You could tell it was just, you know, flesh around the midriff. So that's kind of my 2 cents on this fight. It wasn't entertaining. It was a 10-rounder. Tommy Fury won, as we all thought. I predicted him to win via points, via unanimous decision, which, you know, that is what that is. You know, I was pretty sure I was safe in that bet, and I've got a nice little accumulator coming. I just need AJ to beat the knockout Kubrat Pulev in the first 6 rounds, and I'm good to go. I've made about 80 quid. So hopefully he does the business. In terms of everything else, that's really all I got to say on this. They were talking about Martin Bacoli versus Tommy Fury. I wouldn't mind seeing it. That'd be okay. I'm not sure. See, I thought Tommy Fury signed a 3-fight deal with Eddie Hearn. So if this is 3 fights, Povetkin, Savas, and Vak, that's 3 fights. So is there more fights coming? Is Eddie Hearn going to extend the contract? I don't know. You would imagine, look, I knock Kiwi Fury a lot on this channel, but whenever I knock someone, I feel like it's fair due. I'm not going to hate, I'm not going to say hate, but I'm not going to criticize someone for no apparent reason. I don't do that. Whenever I criticize Kiwi Fury, I think I've been perfectly within my rights. And especially when you hear silliness about, oh, he's only 26. He's been pro since 2013. I mean, seriously. If you've been pro for what, 7 years? Plenty of time. You know, plenty of time. The Charlos turned pro at a very young age. And they were fighting when? Like, they were fighting top guys when they were 26. You know? Just saying. Just saying. They were fighting at a good level when they were 26. You know? Just saying. 4 years ago. Matarossian, I think, Jamel was fighting 4 years ago. Maybe even 5 years ago. And he would have been 25, 26. Just saying. Just saying. Huey Fury, we need to see what he does. They mentioned Joe Joyce on commentary as an opponent for Huey Fury. I mean, I pick Joe Joyce every day of the week, twice on a Sunday, but I can see a conflict of interest there, unless DAZN and Sky Sports know something I don't. We'll have to wait and see. But anyway, those are my thoughts on this. Let me know yours down below. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Hope you liked it. Smash the like if you did. Hashtag GMansRocks, all that good stuff. I'll talk to you, people. Peace.